How you going, people?
Knocking out some videos. It's kind of windy as hell out there, so it's not that cold. It's maybe 55, but that wind is blowing out there. It's cold as hell. And I couldn't hear you if I was outside. I'd rather be outside, but I've been doing most of them in the barn because I get less complaints about the wind. So, I've had a few requests on quite a few videos here, and we're going to do one on pros and cons of open or concealed carry. Should you carry your gun open or concealed? A lot of states are going with open carry. I'm a big open carry guy. I got no problem with it. I think it's a constitutional right. I think everybody should be able to open carry. And I don't think the cops ought to be able to stop and ask you if you got a license. Okay, they just passed open carry in Texas, but it's really not open carry. I talked about it in another video. They made an exception to concealed carry that if you had a concealed carry license, you could now carry open carry. Now, I think retired cops could always carry open carry. I thought there was an exemption for cops or retired cops that you could open carry. But without, you know, most cops aren't going to do it because unless you got your badge displayed and you're working, people are going to be like, why's he got a gun, etc. So, open carry and concealed carry, which one's better, pros and cons? I've had quite a few questions on this. And I'm just giving you my input. I'm not saying it's golden or, you know, you got to believe it. But it is what it is. I like open carry. I don't have a problem with it. Even if I was a cop, I don't have a problem with open carry. Am I going to be more careful with somebody I'm approaching with a gun? Yeah. Am I going to be more alert? Yeah. If I see a guy with prison tattoos open carry versus a guy with a suit and a tie open carry, am I going to treat them different? Yeah. I know. Oh my God, you're profiling, you cops are all crackers, boot lace jacks, boot whatever. Alright, so, what's the pro and con? Okay, concealed carry, one, with a concealed carry holster, I don't think you have to worry about security so much. Okay, when you have a holster, there's called a, I can't think of it now, shit. There's single stage or double stage, or first level threat, or two levels threat, or level two, level three. Something, different companies, I think, AIM, Subway. But basically, you got a holster that the gun just sits in. You got a holster that it sits in with a snap. You got a holster that it sits in with a snap and maybe a button that you have to press. And then when I was working in a really bad area where I used to carry like three guns, I had my gun on my thing, gun on my ankle, gun on my vest, a boot knife, a knife here. When I was working in a real shit area, I had what's called a triple or level three to where I had to unsnap it. Instead of on a button, I had to cant it back in order to get out and then pull to the rear in order for it to unlock to get out. And the reason for that is in this really shit area, the odds of me getting hit and a lot of officers getting knocked down and we're fighting, guys that try to grab our gun, take our gun. So if you're working to where guys are going to be trying to take your gun, then maybe you need those extras. If you're carrying concealed, when I worked undercover, my holster was flat out the easiest, quickest way to get it out. Now, depending on if I figured I was going to be chasing or running or kicking doors, I might have a snap on it because then I would need something to hold the ram or whatever I'm doing. But if I'm just out running around, I want the holster the quickest and easiest to get it out because I know I have a gun, nobody else knows. So holster security isn't as high a priority if you're concealed carry. If you're open carry, and I'll be honest, when they pass open carry, I'm going to open carry just to piss off a liberal. But my holster's not going to have a snap on it. And if you try to take my gun, you better get it. Because if you don't, you're getting shot. Because you just try to commit robbery of a person, which is grand theft at a minimum. Plus you're stealing a gun, which is a felony. Plus if you get my gun, you're going to shoot me so I feel my life's in danger. If you try to take my gun, you better get it or you're going to be dead. So, I mean, I'm not worried about what holster you carry. You just have to be aware on wherever you carry your gun, where it's at. Now, as a cop, I always have my elbow touching my gun or feeling it. Anytime I worked as a cop, when I went to scene, when I was ordering coffee, no matter where I was, that was my crutch, and I would lean on this gun. It kept it in a holster. It let me know if anybody was messing with it. I knew where it was so I could go to it easy. So I always, and most cops, use their elbow forearm to trap that gun or to hold it, or always have what I call gun awareness. Where's your gun at? I know where it's at, and I can go right to it because I feel it with my elbow or arm. So if you're carrying a gun, concealed or unconcealed, you should have gun awareness. If I was going in somewhere to where I didn't want the gun to show up here, I had a holster that was in the back that was canted. So if I reach back here, the handle was right here, and I could just pull it like that. And it didn't have a snap because when I reached back here, I wanted to grab it and pull. So, depending on the holster and where you carry it, the one on my ankle, it always had a snap because I was always running and jumping and climbing fences, and it was a backup gun, and I didn't want it flying out when I'm running. So I definitely wanted to snap on my ankle gun because my ankle, when my feet are running, is taking a lot of jarring and jumping. Not so much here on the hip, but on this foot, it's doing it, especially if you're jumping, landing, climbing a fence, getting hit, etc. So what's the pros and cons to open carry as far as besides being aware? Obviously, if you're open carry, people know you have a gun. So if you've lost the element of surprise, a lot of people like to claim that's why people who open carry are stupid, because you're letting people know you have a gun. Cops open carry every day. They don't call them stupid. Oh, well, that's different. It's not different. You're just a dumbass liberal that can't tell, or you want to carry your gun secretly and hidden. Knock yourself out. If somebody wants to carry their gun out, I don't give a shit. None of my business. It's their gun. They want to strap a rifle on their shoulder, I don't care. Another thing about Texas. I can run around with a loaded AR, go into a restaurant, eat, no problem. Open carry is authorized. But my gun has to be covered until January 1st. And then if you have a concealed permit, then it doesn't have to be covered. You can open carry. But open carry in Texas is still illegal. Anybody tells you open carry now is legal, that's not true. Open carry is illegal. There is an exception or exemption for people with a concealed permit. That way the government maintains the ability, if you're open and carry, you're in violation of law. Now I can contact you because I see a crime. Now I can make you identify yourself and I can make you prove you have a license. Driving a car, you have to have a license, but a cop can't stop you to see if you have a license because driving isn't illegal. There's not an exception. I mean, if you don't drive without a license, that's true. We can't stop people just to see if you have a license. We have to have a crime, and driving is not a crime. Carrying a gun in the open in Texas is still a crime. It's just exempt if you have a license, but it's the burden of proof's on you and the government can ask. You're carrying open carry, that's against the law. I have a concealed carry permit. Oh, you do? Okay, then you're exempt from open carry, no problem, have a nice day. That's the way it should go down. It's not gonna go down that way because you're gonna have ego cops that think we're the only ones that should be open carry and we don't like all these citizens running around with guns and who do they think they are? We're the police and we're ooh-rah. And they're not gonna like open carry, so they're gonna harass people with open carry. Let me see your ID, keep your hands, I'm gonna take your gun, let me secure this. They're gonna treat you as shit, inconvenience you, and make you a pain in the ass so you will not want to open carry. Because that's how government gets people to give up their rights, is they make it so difficult to have those rights, just like the normal guns, taxes, outlawing this, ammo's expensive, background checks, certification, you can't have this, you can't have that. They make it so difficult to exercise that right that over time people just kind of lose that right, give it up, and say, screw it, we haven't done it a long time, who cares? So that's what they're going to do with open carry. I mean, there's going to be some cops. Texas, I think, in your small rural areas, they're not going to care because they know that people who are carrying have background checks, they got their concealed permit, and they're probably a good guy that they're going to back up the cop if they need it, if they're smart. If they're, you know, California cop, damn liberals, brainwashed into. Most California cops are conservative. They're not liberals, and they understand that liberals are idiots. But, you know, when you work in that environment, it kind of rubs off on you a little bit. Pros and cons to it. I mean, to me, there's no really big difference on whether you're open carry or not. If a bad guy wants to come get you, he's going to come get you. If a bad guy walks in a bank and he sees your gun, he may decide not to rob that bank. Because his gun's fake, because his gun ain't loaded, because he's only got one bullet, because he's never shot the gun, because he really doesn't have a gun, he was just going to use his finger and now you got a gun. So people are like, oh, you have a gun on and they rob the bank, they're going to pick you out first. Well, that may be true, but there's a lot of dummies out there that will see that gun and go, you know what, there's a bank where there's not some knucklehead standing here with a gun on. And I'm sure there's going to be banks that are going to say, we don't want people bringing guns in here. They always strike in. Businesses, Buffalo Wings, I don't eat there, they don't get my money. Starbucks, they don't get my money. They don't want guns in their stores. They don't like Second Amendment. They don't like people that carry guns. They don't like people that exercise their rights. You know, they're okay with hiring a gay, lesbian, one-nutted guy with a tit, you know, to serve their stuff because they're liberal progressive, but somebody wants to exercise the Second Amendment. We don't want you in our store. So Starbucks, Wild Wings, there's some other ones out there that are anti-gun, and I don't go there, they don't get my money. And I may go there just for GP when I open carry, just so they have to ask me to leave. So anyway, open carry, concealed carry, it's totally up to you. It can go good or bad. Guys may see it and go, I don't want to mess around. Other guys may say, you know what, we got to take this guy out first. someone may go, you know what, I think I can take that gun. There was one incident, I can't remember, guy walking to Walmart, he was open carrying, and some freaking dumbass tackled him, tried to take his gun, fought him and got his gun. And I hope he got his ass sued. Because, you know, just because somebody has a gun, and there's people posting all, if I see a guy with a gun, I'm gonna run him over, I'm gonna knock him out and take their gun, I'm gonna pepper spray him. There's all kind of idiots out there, because they've been brainwashed that guns are bad unless our protective government that shields us and would never do anything wrong are the only one with guns. I mean, where's the logic in that? It just freaking amazes me that there are people that stupid that think they are safer and more secure when only a government has guns and no one else does. And I mean, if you look back in history, that never works out well. Open carry, concealed carry, your choice, good and bad. Depending on the holster, those are things you want to work about, you know, retaining your gun, learning retention, maybe understanding some retention techniques on your gun, how to get your gun back if it's taken, etc. You know, some people are going to say, well, I'm not going to carry one in the chamber if I open carry, because then if somebody grabs my gun, they're going to have to know to rack around, and I know I got to rack around, so I won't carry one in the chamber. I mean, there's going to be all kind of different things that people are going to do. You know what? Like I said, if you try to take my gun and you get it, good for you. If you don't get it, the price is going to be high, and, you know, it is what it is. We'll end that there.